My name is Alan. I am 52 years old, live in Cottonwood, Arizona, and I have a lump. Quite a large lump, actually. Just noticed it one day, probably about 20 years ago, I had a quarter-sized bump there. I did go to a doctor. They wrote it off as a fatty lump. So I just kind of didn't really play into it too much. And basically has been a gradual growth from there. I'm always active, but I had been heavy off and on all my life. Just knowing that this is actually a fat type of an issue, I kind of thought losing weight would help alleviate that. This last year or so, I've lost probably 50 pounds, but it didn't make a change. It actually, you know, I shrunk, but it got bigger. I'm doing better health-wise, but unfortunately, if I work out, it does hurt. You know, you're always gonna have pain, but it's not good pain. It's not like, you know, my muscles are getting better pain. It's like, that hurts. The other issue that I have is range of mobility. I work on cars for a living, and there's times that if I gotta get my arm buried up in something, it can get in the way or I can catch it. There's times that I come home bleeding from having to reach into things because you gotta get in tight spots sometimes. And with that there, I'm feeling it. I'm actually feeling the thing, and that's what's concerning me. This is beautiful out here today. April is my fiance. She is a woman that came into my life a year and a half ago, and we've been trudging along pretty good ever since.
Get him, all right, get him. Get daddy, go get him.
And she's the reason that we're here today talking, honestly. You've done a lot for me, you know, and it just really, it means a lot. You know, it does. I've never been really much for going to doctors. I'm actually afraid of knives and the doctor and going under. My boss went in for a knee replacement and he died. And that just, when the doctor tells you you're gonna be fine and you're not, I guess that kind of scared me too.
It's one of those things where putting it off for so long and then not knowing what's really even going on down there.
If it is something bad, then we'll deal with it when it gets here. Alan's fears regarding his lump, there's quite a lot of them, actually. He fears going under the knife. He fears that his lump is something really bad, but he needs to quit worrying so much about it and just have the procedure done.
I'm in front of Dr. Lee's office, and I'm kind of anxious, a little scared. There's a lot going through my mind right now. The getting cut open. I don't do good with blood, I guess. I mean, I don't like pass out or nothing, but it's just, I don't like seeing things cut open.
You'll be okay. Just don't puke, okay?
I really don't know how Alan is gonna handle the procedure. I do not think Alan would have come here if it wasn't for me. Definitely a little dragging and screaming to get him here, but the important thing is we're here now.
Alan?
If I can't get through the procedure, it's kind of going to be one of those really big things in my head as to where to go from here.
Hello. Oh,
hi. How are you guys?
I'm Sandra. It's really nice to meet you. Welcome.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
What could I do for you today? What's going on? You hiding something from me?
Yeah, I got a head.
Yeah?
I got an extra forehead.
You do?
Yeah.
Let me see. If you mind, I'm going to give it a touch here. Can you raise your eyebrow for me, too? All right. How long have you had that? That's bigger than a handful.
20 years.
Yeah? It looks like a lipoma, and I feel like this is a Kremser style a little bit, huh?
Yeah.
Can I get the first cut?
I don't know about that.
I just need to get through it.
You do? Are you a little grossed out about this whole thing?
Well, no, I think I'll be good.
I'm sensing a bit of hesitation for Alan. I'm not sure if he's really scared of pain, of doctors, of needles, but you know, a little bit of apprehension is normal.
Just you keep your eyes closed and we'll keep our eyes open, okay?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm gonna get all set up and you get your mind around this too. And I'll see you in a little bit. You okay? Okay. All right, good.
Cool.
I'm excited for you. I'll see you in a little bit.
Thank you. Awesome. Oh, I hope I don't throw up.
Okay, I think we got a pretty sizable head-shaped, probably lipoma on this gentleman's arm. He gets a little queasy with things, so he's not gonna look. So keep an eye on him when we're doing surgery. And let me know if you have any questions or anything.
I'm nervous just the fact that they're gonna cut me open, the fact that I don't know what's in there. The blood. April is basically gonna be holding my hand through this procedure. She does better with these kind of things than I do.
Okay, so what I'm gonna do first is we're gonna put that numbing in there, and then we're gonna let it sit for a couple minutes here, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You okay? See how it feels maybe a little tight, but not bad, huh?
I'm not feeling nothing right now.
I need
to relax. I don't know why I'm getting so tense right now.
Don't worry, you don't get so tense here. Usually what happens is once you start doing it, you realize it's like such a piece of cake, like you don't feel anything, you're like happy it's gone and you're just chatting with us. Are you okay?
I deal with anxious patients on a daily basis, but there are some people who really can't endure that type of surgery. If they are too anxious, they really need to be considered for general anesthesia. I would love to help Alan. I'm sure he wants my help, but it really is not safe for me to operate on a person like this if he's that agitated.
I get in my head just, you know, a little anxiety, but I'll make it. I'm really anxious right now. I don't know if I could even go through this. God, I don't know why I turn into such a wuss as I get older.
Want a little something to relax you? Probably should have given that to you a little bit before.
Give me one. What the heck?
In extreme cases, when a patient is really nervous, if they're experiencing a lot of anxiety, I can give them some medications that will help to relax them.
Okay.
Can we get him a little blanket or something?
I want Alan to be as comfortable as possible.
How are you doing?
Let's do it.
Okay, you shouldn't feel anything like I said, okay? Stop your sighing. You're doing fantastic.
Just stuff that looks like chicken, basically, coming out of his arm. It's adorable.
You doing all right?
Oh, yeah.
Alan seems to have relaxed a bit, but I want to move pretty quickly because I don't want to give him too much time to think about what's happening.
All right, we got it all out. But I'm just going to stitch it, and then you're out of here.
I knew you could do it.
I had doubts you could do it. There's just fluid there a little. Actually, you can see the definition of your deltoid now, huh?
Wow. It's amazing. You know, I'm glad that I was able to stick through and get through the procedure and not cop out like I have in the past. Awesome.
It looks good.
Yeah, it does. Really good. That. Thank you.
You're gonna see. It'll be like that. It'll be flatter tomorrow.
Yeah.
Anyway, you wanna weigh it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's 3 pounds.
Wow.
Alan is 3 pounds lighter, but I did spot a little skin tag, so I thought I'd give him a little extra oomph, like a little skin tag bonus, and take that off for him.
Now that I'm not coming at you with anything sharp, now you're all calm, so that's great.
Thank you.
Take care, we'll see ya.
Thank
you, sweetie. You take good care of him. Keep taking good care of him. Keep giving him hell.
Oh, I will.
I know.
For the rest of his life.
Yeah, I needed pretty much everything other than a stuffed animal to get me through the procedure, but I made it. It kind of renewed my confidence in doctors. In hindsight, I wish I would have got it done sooner. I'm very grateful to Dr. Lee. She has honestly changed my life.
It's been 9 weeks since Alan's surgery. He looks fantastic. He's back to working out with no discomfort. I think he's really happy with his results. Good luck, Alan.